That's impressive. You must say that. Ooh, impressive. Yeah, look at the holes in the walls where the cars were. You can see the holes. So what other nice thing about this hotel is they have a store. It has souvenirs, but it also has groceries, camping supplies, firewood, post office, quite a bit. It's a pretty large store. So, I mean, as far as this hotel rooms, it was your typical Best Western hotel room, but a lot of nice amenities, really close to the park. The shuttle picks you up right over there to go into Bryce Canyon, so definitely would recommend it here. That plus the supercharger or the destination chargers was a pretty good deal. So, okay, we're gonna pack up and head out now. Had a good breakfast. Breakfast was included too, by the way, so that was another thing that was nice. But we're gonna head out, get a move on. All right, we got out of here earlier than we have anywhere else. I didn't drop a bag today and break anything.
We even had breakfast.
Even had a full breakfast. Delicious. So we're gonna head up one more time before we head out and get a picture at the sign, and then I need the passes in the backpack, and then we're heading on. So
you have to have that pass for the sign.
I don't know. It's a sign this side of the.
It's right here. You see it up there?
Okay. All right. May not need the pass. We'll do that, and then we'll be on the road. Alright, so I plugged in our destination, Zion National Park. So we're going straight from Bryce to Zion. If you notice, sometimes you may have to go out to I-15 and back over. We're going to be able to go straight there. We got 94% state of charge once we went up, took our picture, headed back. We're going to have 74 when we get there. And now only 32 if we were round trip, but I'm pretty sure we can get it from Zion. From what I looked at, a better route planner, we can get from Zion into St. George to the supercharger and have like 30 or 40%. So we should be in really good shape to take the trip we want to take today. I hope we just don't have to do a ton of driving in Zion, but we'll have to keep an eye on that. In fact, once we get to Zion, I'll probably plug in St. George as our destination so I keep track of what percentage we'll have to get to St. George. I wish Elon would get waypoints set up in the car. If he would get waypoints set up, then we could hit Zion and St. George and know how we're doing the whole way. But unfortunately, as you all know, we can only do that on a better route planner. So anyway, that's what we're doing now, heading out of Bryce Canyon. Had a great time, highly recommend it. It's a great place to go. Yeah. Okay, so we were noticing that it's a pretty strong wind. We've been watching flags, pretty strong wind coming right at us from the south, and our efficiency is definitely suffering for it. You can see we were gonna get there with 72, now we're 70. So we got behind this motorhome, who's going decent speed. He was going about 60 miles an hour. The speed limit was 60 at the time. So I think we're just gonna camp out behind him, keep our efficiency up as high as we can. I mean, I'm not worried, but it is super windy today, so something interesting. I haven't had this kind of a wind effect before, so we're going to continue on, and we're just going to sit behind him and see if we can draft at least for another, I don't know,
maybe miles. He's going to be turning.
22 miles. Oh, he's leaving us. Oh, so much for my wind resistance.
Well, you'll have to find someone else.
Find somebody else to draft. National Park straight. We're going to Zion. No Grand Canyon, we go straight.
It's far away.
It's
like
a quick trip?
Many. I already looked to see if we could make a quick trip. It's like 5 hours. We just don't have the time.
Zion National Park, 12 miles, $25 entrance fee. Not for us! National Park miles for a year. So we got over 72. We're here at the campgrounds are full. Good thing we're not camping. But not too bad. Better than I thought with the wind. So into the park we go. Okay, we are now in Zion. I'm not sure what to expect other than American beauty. God's beauty of America. What are we looking at here? Oh, look at that hill. Yeah. This side is very interesting. It's interesting. It's
checkerboard.
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 This thing reminds me of this guy's walking. I'm walking the clock. Eyes peeled, I'm sure there'll be more. Oh, what up there? Get that up there. Look at that up there.
I can't get that from here.
Is that like,
I'm in the back seat, not the front.
Okay, we'll pull over over here then.
It's gonna
get blocked. Looks like design, a drawing, doesn't it? Like, yeah. Up there? Another Tesla. Braving Zion National Park. Hello, Tesla owners. Model 3. Just look at that. Is it like where water normally comes down?
Get that
like?
Crevasse. Get that crevasse. Get it. Get that crevasse. It's a nice crevasse.
That's what he said. Waiting for a tunnel. This is the tunnel you are waiting for, Michael. You know that? This is the tunnel you were hoping for? Nice hats. How's it so far, babe?
Good.
Okay. Those are rocks.
I like rocks.
And watch
them. All right, here we go. Sunglasses. We'll be right back.
sure?
No, I saw lots of things down there.
Oh, look, it's going out there, so maybe so.
Yeah, it goes all the way down there.
I wonder if it said 12 miles to the visitor center. It's not like 12 miles away, it's 12 miles down. You have to keep going around and around. Like, these are a ton of switchbacks we're doing.
Yeah, you do a bend over there, a corner over there, and then that corner, and then it's...
Then we're down?
Yeah, take a left.
Oh, you're watching the map?
Yeah, I have the map.
Michael has the map. National Park. And we're gonna have to take a shuttle just like we did yesterday. No cars allowed up to the front part. So we're gonna hit the visitor center first and then head to the shuttle. Nice to visit, nice to see, but I think we pretty much could have just driven through and not stopped. We took a bus, waited forever to park. Once we parked, we took a bus up, and really, unless you're hiking, there's no point in taking the bus up because you can, everything you saw on the way in, you can pretty much see. And there's a couple things to see, but hiking is definitely the thing to do there if you're going to Zion. So now we're gonna go to St. George, get a hotel for the night, and then I don't know from there. We're just gonna get some litter, probably litter. But it's definitely beautiful out here. Cool to see. So, but I like Bryce better. I just thought Bryce was. I like the town. I like the little short walk up to see that canyon was amazing. So, all right, we'll just
keep. Zion doesn't much, I think.
It is. It was different. I don't know, the Red Rock area, the Red Canyon and Zion Bryce. I like that. Personally, for me, I like it better. Zion's nice, but
I think you were, what we saw coming in
was amazing.
What there is
yeah.
to see.
Yeah.
You were expecting to go.
And we came in from the east, too. That's important to note. We came in from the east. So if you're coming in from the south, you're like through the town of Springvale, and boom, you're right into the park. And you almost need to go out to the east exit to see what we saw.
Yes.
But if you're coming in from the east, then yeah, you can just continue driving through probably. Once you've seen that, you've probably seen most of it, so. All right. Good day. It was a good day overall. I had a good time. I just want to get to some place and get some dinner. Says we're gonna get there with fact, we may just go and do dinner first and charge afterwards and not even worry about charging once we get to town. So. Freddy's is what we're gonna do for dinner again, because we love the fries, those little string, little shoestring fries, and the burgers, and the custard. So we're gonna head to Freddy's, which is up here, the supercharger up here on Convention Center Drive. So we're gonna do that, and then I don't know, we have the hotel yet either, so we have to, at some point, figure out a hotel. Yeah. One step at a time, food for us, so we're not angry. Okay, so Mama decided she wanted to go as far north as we could tonight. So back towards Salt Lake. So we're sitting right now at St. George with 39% state of charge. We know we can go up to Beaver and charge at a 250. So we're gonna charge here at a 150. It originally wanted us to go to Cedar City, but that's like a 56 watt charger. We're like, no, let's just go back down to the 150 in St. George. So we're gonna charge here, then we're gonna head up north to Beaver, and then we're not sure how far we're gonna go tonight until we're ready to stop. Now, looking at efficiencies, so far, that's since 5:33. So 240 since the last charge, which was this morning. So that was really good. A lot of slow driving to the parks and whatnot. So that's pretty cool. And then so far for the trip, 301, with just a hair over 300 now, thanks to this last leg. So we're gonna be going north on 15, and it'll probably be going pretty fast, so I think we're going to lose efficiencies going north. Although I think we have a tailwind, because we had a headwind coming south, so hopefully if the wind's still going, we'll have a tailwind pushing us up north. So let's get charged and we'll head up the road. We left the supercharger at 80% state of charge, more than we needed to. It's back more than it told us we needed to continue our journey. It says we're going to get Beaver with 26%. I'm interested to see if the tailwinds are still out there and if we do get better efficiency than that. So we'll see. We'll probably keep it about 80. And we'll see how things go. Yeah. So right now,
I want to rip it. I want to get there.
271. Yeah. 301 so far, so we'll see.
Rip it.
Rip it 88.
Rip it real good.
Mama wants to go 88 miles an hour.
Rip it real good.
I want to go within the legal.
Okay, 80 is the speed limit, so.
Well, come on, a little over 80 is the.
Oh, how much over 80? This is the first time I've heard you agree to that.
5 miles over is
85 is what we're going to go. Okay.
Five is the max.
In 500 feet, take the interstate.
We'll be going 85.
I usually do 3 to 4. Five is max.
3 to 4 or 5 is max. Mm-hmm. Today we're going 5. All right. We can do that.
But if you get a ticket, it's not my fault.
If we get a ticket, it's not my fault. You authorized the speed.
No, you chose the speed that
No, way. I chose 80. You said, I want to go faster.
Okay, go 80.
Now take the interstate 15.
I want to get a ticket and blame you. I do. You said 85.
I said go 80.
You said 5 over. Officer, my wife said 5 over is okay. Is she wrong? Wait, is my wife wrong, officer? To what, 31-32% efficiency. We do have a strong tailwind blowing us. I have been driving pretty much 85%, and we did pull off 85 miles an hour, sorry. And I did pull off in Parowan and make a little detour real quick, so that took a little bit of extra. But overall, 28, even with the speeds we're driving, so not too bad. Efficiency so far for this charge, 343, so not good, attributed to my speed of driving. And overall for the trip, 303, so still not doing bad for the trip overall. So we're gonna pull off here in Beaver and get ourselves charged up pretty high, because I don't know how far we're gonna go tonight, but we'll charge up so we've got plenty of charge, so we don't have any restrictions on where we go. So pulling off. Open. See what kind of speeds we're getting?
Dun, 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 dun. Well, that guy moved. His must not have been working.
That one wasn't good working again. Remember, first cabinet wasn't working good.
He wasn't on the first.
I think he was. 1 8. It's 4. A, B, C, D. 198, 200, 210, 212, 220, 225. We are not going to hit 1,000 miles an hour. We are too high state of charge. If I let it drain a little more, if I would have ripped it a little more, yeah, we hit a max at 225. And we're going down. Not too bad. Let's see here. That's to get us to 90%. I think we'll let it go 35 minutes. I think that's not a bad play. Now time for backgammon?
Yes.
Backgammon, let's do it. Got here with 16%, which I think is about 2% better than what we were supposed to get preconditioning. So let's go plug her in and get charging. So these are the ones we did back on Sunday. These are V3s. Ooh, almost fell off the curb. Come on, baby. Let's see what we get.
And if we look at our trip right here, our energy. Oh wow, that's weird. it's really weird.
The trip, yeah. Okay, let's see where we're charging at.
No, you're gonna get copyright strike.
We might get up to 1,000 miles a minute. I'm feeling it. Although we're probably cold. Because we should have. I didn't have the destination set as a supercharger. I had it set as a Draper, so. Unfortunately, we were not preconditioning until the last couple of seconds when Michael changed the supercharger, so we're not going to get the speeds that I would have liked. But let's see if she warms up what we can get up to. Da, da, da. Getting higher. By the way, if I haven't said before, I mean, I've said it before in other videos, but you haven't heard that it says $9. But that's from a December 27th charge we did When we brought the car home from Rockland to Redding, we stopped in Woodland, and we did not have free supercharging yet. The free supercharging for a year kicked in afterwards, so now we haven't been paying at all this whole trip. So haven't been paying since December 28. No, I think it was January or something. So it's supercharging for a year. Okay, we're not gonna get up there. It's maxing out about 212, so not too bad, but we will sit here. We might charge up. We'll see how much we charge up. We're getting kind of tired. We're gonna look for a hotel somewhere around here and then call it a night. So maybe one with a destination charger. We'll see. We charged up to 75%. We decided to get a hotel in Layton, which is up north of Salt Lake. Mikey and I tomorrow want to go to the Hill Air Force Base Museum.
Hill Aerospace.
It's at Hill Air Force Base. The Hill Aerospace
Museum. I will show you.
I trust you. Anyways, this is going to give us enough charge to get up there, have the car sit overnight, also have us drive around a little tomorrow, and then come back down here to charge up. And I don't know where we're going to spend the night tomorrow night. We're still not sure.
What does that say?
It's the Hill Aerospace Museum. Congratulations.
I'm gonna
Hill Air Force Base. Okay.
I'm gonna flip a coin.
So gonna drive another. Looks like 31 minutes. We'll be at our hotel before midnight. Yay! And then Mama can sleep in tomorrow when Mikey and I check out the museum. So heading up to Layton. Okay. Well, it's 11:55. We finally made it to Layton. We're staying at the Courtyard by Marriott. It's been a long day. A lot of stuff we saw, but we're gonna head to bed. Tomorrow we're gonna check out I think an Air Force museum, and don't know what else. Do some shopping maybe before we start heading back towards home. So have a good night. If you like this video, like and subscribe, and we'll catch you on the next one.